Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new to the channel, I am Meg, and today I am doing a US mini haul as well as a little review of my Sephora Australia purchase. Now, excuse the oily face. This has been on me since this morning, so I don't actually have foundation on. It's just a little bit of powder, and now it's worn off. Okay, so let's talk. I was actually in the middle of filming this when somehow my camera decided to have an error and didn't save any of the 10 minutes that I already was talking. But anyway, so I guess I'll start off with a review of the products that I have purchased from Sephora recently. I think it's been about 2 weeks since I've received it. I've been using it in that 2 weeks, so I could give you a good idea of what I think about them. First of all, let's do random. One of the things that I bought were these Zoeva Rose Gold brush set. Now, I don't really know how to review brushes. I mean, they do the job. I've washed them, they haven't shed. There's been, the blush brush in the set actually did shed maybe one or two hairs, but so far I haven't done so after another wash. So far, so good. Yeah, really nothing much. Because they're white-haired brushes, I find that they can get stained, especially with reds and blues, but I've used my Daiso sponge cleaner as well as the Dr. Bronner's castor soap, so that actually works out well. Now, the next thing, a bit random as well, is the Hans de Fuko Gravity Paste, which is the hair paste or wax that I've been using. As you can see, I've got rather short hair, so I need some kind of product to keep it together. And I really like this compared to the other hair products that I've been using, like hair wax, because this doesn't give me that I have dandruff look. The other paste that I've been using is when it dries, it gives me like a little bit of flaky look that it looks like I've got dandruff on. I've got dandruff, but I don't. This one doesn't do that, and it really does hold my hair, but not stiff hold that you can't run your fingers through it. I can still do that. It's still soft, but it keeps the hair in place, especially when you've got like little baby hairs that I do. So far, so good. You would have already seen me do a get ready with me first impressions kind of thing for the next product, which is the Huda Beauty Electric Obsessions palette. This one here, if you haven't actually seen this product before. But what I did say there is that while I do enjoy the colors that are in here, I was a little bit disappointed with how it transfers to the eyelids, because as you can see on the palette, the colors look very bright and vibrant, but that's not how it translates when you actually apply it on your lids. It's okay because I don't really have shades like this, so I am going to go ahead and keep this and not declutter it or pass it on, because they are beautiful. They are beautiful shades. However, like I said, they are not as vibrant as I thought they would be. It's a little bit misleading, to be honest, but it's okay because I just ordered the Zulu palette from Juvia's Place. It should take another 2 weeks to get here to Australia. They now offer international shipping, and I think I paid $7 for shipping. And yeah, so, and it was on sale from $21 to $17.50, and then at the time that I ordered it, there was also a promotion to use the code HOT30 for 30% off, so I ended up paying like under $20 to get the palette plus the ship, including the shipping cost. Anyway, now the other product that I ordered, which I don't think I've done a proper review of yet, is this Marc Jacobs Frivolox palette. It's one of his like 7 pan palettes. Now, I was really hesitant to buy this because it's expensive. It's like $60-something here in Australia, and for 7 shades, that's like $10 per pan almost. I think it's $68, but there was a 10% off for Beauty Insiders, so I took advantage of that and got this. And I thought I wasn't gonna like it, to be honest, because I was like, I'm not really a fan of cool tones. When I opened it the first time, I was like, oh, how am I going to use this? I'm not sure. Maybe I should just return it and stuff like that. But nothing else in his collection intrigued me enough for me to actually exchange this in. But then I started using it, and I've been using it, like I said, for the last 2 weeks, and I am quite impressed by this eyeshadow formula. I was thinking, how much different could it be? Now, these eyeshadows are quite soft, a little bit powdery, to be honest, but the pigmentation, the blendability, it just glides on and stays on. That's what I like about it. The only thing that I am not a big fan of is this shade here, which is called Always. And to be honest, I don't understand it, because I don't know if you can actually see it on camera, but it's got silver glitter in there. And I am trying to use it as my transition shade, but I don't understand why it's got glitter. I end up having silver glitter on my face when I use it, because it doesn't even stay on the lids. It just keeps falling. So that's my only con for this, and well, obviously the price as well. But it feels really very luxurious. And while I have tried many other formulas of eyeshadows, I think this one is really good. I just won't be buying any more because it's expensive. Okay, now let's do a mini haul. Now, I ordered a few things from Sephora in the US when they had the VIB sale, but I did also order this Bad Habit palettes. Now, I don't know if there was a glitch in their system. I know that these ones were only available on their app, but for some reason I was able to order them from their website. Because I can't download the app because it's a US only app. It's not even available on the Australian market. Even if I wanted to, I just can't. But for some reason, when I went on their website through my phone, if I go via my computer, I think it detects something, so I can't purchase it. But when I went to the website through my phone, I think it thought that it was an app. So I don't know, but there must have been a glitch in the system because I was able to order these. Each of these are supposed to be $16, so it's like $32 for the two of them. But when you buy them in a bundle, it's only $24, I believe. So I got these. Now, I'm a little bit disappointed because when I opened this Solstice palette here, and I'll show you, because I've actually already looked at them, because how do you control yourself, right? Okay. Actually, the color Race, which is a glittery color, was broken. So this one here was broken. I had to repress it. I was intending to put this in a giveaway, but well, that's not gonna happen anymore because it was broken when it arrived. And it looks like it was broken from the warehouse because everything else is intact, including my Supernova palette was intact. There were no damages on it. It's just this particular palette has got that. Now it smells really good because I used a I didn't have alcohol in the house, so I used a perfume, Grace by Philosophy, to actually press that in, and it worked. It's a golden sort of glittery shade called Grace. Yeah, so I guess I'm keeping this. I was actually really intending to put that in a giveaway, but this one I definitely will be keeping. This is the Supernova palette. I believe this one, if you know Shop Hush, they sell products that are pretty much dupes of high-end products. This one is supposed to be a dupe of the Natasha Denona Sunset palette. And Supernova is supposed to be the dupe for the Natasha Denona Lila palette. Okay, and this one looks like this here. I've seen a lot of comparisons, and they are pretty much spot on, with probably very little difference in terms of the pigmentation or how it swatches, but on the eyes they look pretty much spot on. So I mean, even if it were the full price of $16, it's nothing compared to the $129 that the Lila palette is. Okay, so definitely, and was really interested in this shade, but now that I have this, and I've seen this swatch next to the, what is the shade that's on the Lila palette? I think it's the Amethyst shade, but whatever is the counterpart of this on the Lila palette. I've seen the swatch side by side and they are pretty much the same, if not exactly the same. And I realize now that I have this shade in one of my Inglot singles. So I'm happy that I got this, but the reason that I got it is because of this shade here, and I actually have it on my Inglot. But the shades are beautiful, so I will be doing a get ready with me and first impressions, maybe, and quite possibly a full review of the palettes right here. Really liking that. I've actually already sent an email to Shop Posh complaining about this Solstice palette being broken on arrival, because obviously this doesn't have any damage in it and the other shades in here doesn't have any damage in it, so I think it's fair for me to assess that the damage happened during the warehouse before it was shipped. Okay, then there was a Sephora order that I did. I'll start with the samples, which I don't know if I'm even going to use it. They gave me the Grand Lips Hydra Plump Longwear Semi-Matte sample. I'm pretty sure I didn't choose this. I did choose, however, the Marc Jacobs Shameless 24-Hour Foundation sample. I think I am going to actually end up being a medium Y390. So I'll probably end up like mixing these two to get my shade, so I can be able to try it out. And then the last one is the Vanish Seamless Finish Foundation Stick from Hourglass, which I also did not choose, but they always send me random shit. Okay, what I did actually buy from Sephora are these. These are the Glitter On The Go Liquid Shadow from Stila, and it comes with Rose Gold Retro, Kitten Karma, and Smoldering Satin. I will be reviewing. I'm sure there's a lot of reviews out there on YouTube already, so you probably don't even want to hear my opinion, but I'm gonna try it out. I'm gonna see how it goes. I've got super duper oily lids. Let's see if this is gonna stay, because I've heard so many good things about this and I have a feeling I'm gonna be disappointed, but we'll see. Next thing that I got is a Becca Ambient Chase. Ambient Chase. I am mixing Becca with Hourglass. Light Chaser Highlighter for eyes and for face and eyes, and this is the Amethyst Flashes Geode. This is originally $34. It was down 50% to only $17, so I thought, hey, let's get it on. And it looks like that. It is gorgeous. This is the flying saucer sort of look. It's really appealing to me. Very nice compact. I really like how this looks, and hopefully I am going to like how it applies as well. I was thinking this would be not really a blush topper, but I was thinking this might work as a blush on me instead of just a blush topper, so we will see. I also did order the Origins Drink Up Intensive. They've got a new packaging because it's winter right now here, or coming into winter here in Australia, and my skin is drying up. So this used to be just plain green, but now it's got some sort of design on it. But yeah, really like this. Love the smell of it. Love how my skin feels the next day when I use this. So definitely a staple in my collection. Now the last thing that I bought, it's not from Sephora. This was, and I don't know why I did this. I didn't need another one of these, but I thought, oh my God, it's gorgeous. I need to have it. And it is the, what is it called? Rosemantic shade. Let me look at that. Even the box is gorgeous. From Smashbox, which is a collaboration with Vlada, the makeup artist. And look at that. Now, I know that this is coming to Mecca here in Australia, but I also know that it was sold out. So it's a good thing that I actually bought it. This was freaking $39. that's like 50, probably more, 50 Australian dollars, but I don't care. I love it. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to use it because it's just so gorgeous. And inside, the mirror actually says Vlada, a Smashbox plus Vlada, but holy crap, look at that. Look at how beautiful that thing is. I don't know if I even want to swatch it because I think I'm going to ruin the look of it. But anyway, what I'll probably do is actually swatch this, not live, because I want to take pictures of it before I actually swatch it, and then I'm going to post it in this video so you guys can see what it looks like swatched on medium skin like myself. For reference, I am an NC35 right now, but during the summer I'm an NC40, so maybe that'll give you an idea of how tan I am. All right, now this video is taking too long. It says there 16 minutes. If you have any questions on my purchases, let me know. If you want to see a full review of any of these products, I am going to go ahead and do that for you guys. I also wanted to mention that there's going to be some changes in this channel because, let's face it, I'm never going to be a beauty blogger like how other beauty bloggers are, where, you know, I'm just not. So I think I'm going to start talking about other things that matter to me, current events, probably not politics, because I'm not sure if you even follow Australian politics. Not that I'm really that interested. I'm probably more interested in Philippine politics because that's where I'm from. But anyway, current events, things that matter to me, opinions, and whatever. So yeah, so those are the things that you probably can expect. I mean, obviously I'm not gonna be like too out there or whatever, but you know, still sticking to my conscious consumer mindset, I guess, and like really asking questions that are relevant to us beauty lovers. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all again in the next video. If you like this video, do give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and also, what else am I gonna say? Oh, hit that notification button so that you are informed of when I upload my videos, which is usually Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Bye!